On the 25th of November, I arrived early at the meeting point for the eco-cultural tour of Chiang Rai that was an optional part of the ASEAN Eco-Criticism Conference held at the May Pha Luang University in Chiang Rai, Thailand. This little shop right inside the E4 building of the university was open, and I got me some iced tea and puff cake. And Lou J gave us these Ovaltine popsicle-shaped candy. We have these in the Philippines, but they're small and round and do not come in a stick. We call them Ovaltinis. This one is huge, and we all found it a little comical. After a short wait, we were asked to go where the vans were waiting so that we can already start the tour. This is actually day 3 of the conference, but it is no longer part of the conference proper. The conference proper ended the previous day, and I have logs about them, which I will link down below. Like I said, this is the eco-cultural tour, which is optional. I opted to take it because I have never been to Thailand before, and this is a tour organized by academics. It should be interesting, with places that are still related to eco-criticism. In the van, we had an assigned driver and tour guides, and we were given snacks. Again, these adorable little things that come in such beautiful presentation. Now, this was an all-day tour, and there were quite a few places that we stopped at. I will provide information here as much as I can with links down below in the description box, but for the most part, I will just be taking you along for the day, and I will keep as much of the original sound on as I can, just so you can get more of the feel of the places that we went to, except on some parts where there were personal conversations going on that I accidentally captured on video. Our first stop was this place. It is at the foot of the hill, and it is a gift shop that we walked around in, and we also used the bathroom. But the main attraction is really a little bit higher up. Come, walk with me.
Okay, I'll go ahead and 1, 2, 3, 5. voelen dat ze dan echt zo, als ze in het eerste jaar dan zo lang
in some form, yeah.
You have been seeing. Mostly it says it's this one. Yeah, you have to see.
So if you want to contribute to the piece, don't go to class.
Yeah.
What
do you mean? Okay, go. Okay, go.
What's your genre?
This is the Doi Tung Palace, which used to be the residence for the work of Her Royal Highness Princess Srinagarindra. There is an official website about the place, and I will link it in the description box. There was kind of a long walk up, but the place is so beautiful and it is sunny, but the air is very cool and fresh. At the entrance to the actual palace, we were given these audio players with earphones and these bags to put our shoes in. And the way it works is, as you walk around the place, there are numbers shown right beside the displays, and you just press that corresponding number on your player, and the player tells you what the display is all about. Taking of videos, however, is not allowed inside the palace, only until here at the foyer and outside on the balconies. So let me just show you around a little bit, and then later on as I go along, I'll just share some of the pictures that I took. According to my audio player, the palace is still the residence of the princess and her family, so there were places that were cordoned off, but we were given access to the halls where the displays were. This is the view from one of the balconies. We were given enough time to go around, but I kind of felt like I needed more time. The place is so wonderful, and there was so much information on my player, but there were also other places to go to, so we all had to walk back down after a while. The next stop had us walking through this maze made of dirt and bamboo, and this is actually land being used by the Thai army. It is called Doi Chang Mup, and it's right at the border of Myanmar and Thailand. There is a tiny coffee shop here from which I ordered a tea, and it was really, really good. My friends who ordered the coffee said that the coffee was also great. After a short stay, we all went back down through the maze again because it was already time for lunch. But on the way to lunch, some uniformed personnel checked the passengers in all of the vehicles going through this particular road, and we were asked to display our passports beside our face, and someone took our picture. Finally, we have arrived at our lunch place at the Akha village. Lunch has already been prepared and served on the tables, and the presentation is once again very, very nice. And I like the chairs. They're made of wood, but they swivel. See? While waiting for everyone else to settle in, we went to the terrace. The food was so good, as I expected. Even the super spicy ones, I managed to have a decent portion of, because once you get past the spiciness, they really taste very good. After lunch, we were treated to a presentation. Our next stop was the Tham Luang Cave Complex, where a bunch of kids and their coach got lost in the year 2018. And they were rescued, but one of the rescuers died during the mission. I will leave some links about it in the description box. Come, walk with me. Inside, it was muddy, as most caves are, and I was afraid of slipping, like I always am, but I still managed to walk around. I did it very, very carefully, and I was thinking that there were people that can help me up in case I slip, but thankfully, I did not slip. But my sweater got some mud on the hem, and that's okay. I managed to clean up most of it very quickly. Our next stop was at Chiang Saen in the ancient capital of Lhana. This is still in Chiang Rai.
Like,
yeah, the ruins were well preserved, and there was there.
Para
may iba naman. Core memory talaga. Tas alam mo yung na finalize.
From here, trams took us around to the other temples in the area. We were also able to drop by this museum. Come, walk around with me. Our final stop was at the Golden Triangle, which is called that because it is located where we can all see three different countries in a single sweeping view. Thailand, where we are, Laos, which is right across Mekong River over here, and Myanmar over there. In this specific frame, you can see all three countries together. I'm standing on Thailand, Laos is on the upper right corner, and Myanmar is on the upper left corner in those mountains way beyond the Golden Statue. This is my first time ever to see the Mekong River in person, and it's really, really majestic. I am in awe. We were all tired, so my friends and I dropped by this 7-Eleven, and I am so floored by all of the wonderful things that they have in here that we don't have in 7-Eleven in the Philippines. Even the fisherman's friend here has flavors that I have never seen in our little neck of the woods. And look, they even have frozen durian popsicles. I ended up buying a crab sandwich, a pandan cream cake slice, a chocolate pudding thing, milk, and a chicken and cream little sandwich that I asked the staff to heat. And then I just sat at a waiting shed nearby to have some quiet time to myself while eating. We all got back to the van shortly afterwards and started the journey back to the main Pha Luang University campus while I was eating this crab sandwich that is really, really good. Back at the university, my friends and I decided to take a public transportation from the E4 building to the gate of the university. It was a very, very short ride. Each person's fare is 10 baht, and people can pay using a QR code. That is so cool. It was a long day, but very fulfilling. I'm glad I opted to join this tour.